two, three, go.
Two, three. Yeah! Welcome to Geek World.
Oh, so silence.
Hey guys, welcome to Geek World. Oh, science.
Yay!
Yay!
Hey guys, welcome to another episode of Gideon's World of Science. This is our second episode where we do cool, fun science experiments from home, all out of basic stuff that you either have lying around the house or really cheap stuff that you can go and buy at the store. So this episode is all about, can you say, force and motion?
Force and motion.
Force and motion. Basically, there's some energy stuff, but anyway. I'm not a science teacher. We will make Sir Isaac Newton proud.
Yes! Newton!
Alright, so, first one. Are you ready for this one?
Yep. All we need is a bottle, a dollar to put on top, and these corners.
What this is just a basic experiment showing how inertia works.
Inertia.
Inertia is basically when something will remain unchanged, whether that's sitting still or in motion. If something's sitting still, it's going to stay sitting still. If something's moving, it's going to keep moving unless acted upon by an outside force. That's actually Newton's first law. Did you know that?
Yeah! Yes!
I'm surprised you knew that. Normally, if you were to just grab this dollar bill and yank on it, try that. The coins fall. Gideon was an outside force and grabbed the dollar bill, pulling on it, making the quarters fall. We're going to try to create least amount of friction as possible, and we're going to pull on this dollar bill super fast. In fact, we're going to karate chop it. Are we ready?
Yeah.
One, two, three, go. Oh! High five, dude.
I got 1 point.
We did it. So basically what happened was Gideon moved the dollar bill fast enough to where we didn't create hardly any friction, and that dollar was able to slide out from underneath the coins, leaving them in place. We're going to up the ante a little bit. You ready?
Yeah.
One, two,
three.
Three, you ready? You're not ready. You ready?
Yeah.
Okay. Almost feels good as a marker flip.
Yeah.
Okay, so this one is also about inertia. This one's a little bit cooler. What we're gonna do is all you need is a glass with a little bit of water in it because it adds some weight. We're gonna put the lid on top. Then we're gonna take a little roll of toilet paper. You wanna line it up to where it's directly over top of the glass, yeah. Like so.
And you use all orange.
But we're gonna use an orange. Okay, be really easy, easy, easy. So you know how you did yours with the orange, okay? Just one by itself?
Yes, and I hit it and it worked on the cup.
We're gonna up the ante. So we got 5 glasses here. We're gonna put some water in each one.
Green, blue, red, black, another red.
The color's not important. We just wanted to do colored water to be fun. So we got 5 eggs on toilet paper rolls on the plate over 5 glasses. Daddy's gonna hit the plate and hopefully all 5 eggs drop in. Are we ready for this?
Yes.
You ready?
One. 2, 3.
Woo!
We did it! We got so many eggs!
Made it happen. Okay, Gideon. Now this one is more about force. We're gonna deal with, can you say, centrifugal?
Centrifugal.
Pretty close. And centripetal.
Centripetal.
Centrifugal and centripetal force. So how we're going to demonstrate that is with a balloon with a penny inside. See? We're going to spin the balloon, and as we spin the balloon, we're going to create centrifugal force, which is pushing the penny outward towards the outside of the balloon. But centripetal force is actually the layer of balloon, which is holding the penny inside, okay? Drawing it back towards the center. Are we ready? So all we got to do is start spinning it. Spin, 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 spin. See the penny inside?
You spin the leg of Earth.
Check it out.
Can I try?
You sure can. Perfect. Pretty cool, huh? Now this is the same experiment, only instead of a penny, we got a hex nut. You wanna show them how the hex nut works?
Yeah.
We put a hex nut in there. What it does is as those sides hit the edge of the balloon, it makes noise, it vibrates. So, get it spinning. If you got a lot of these going at once, it'd probably make a lot of noise. See how loud I can get it. It's fun, isn't it?
Science is fun.
Okay, getting you ready for our next experiment?
Yes.
Okay, this one's more about energy. This is more like potential energy and kinetic energy. And we're going to build, it's called a popsicle stick bomb. We're going to weave them across, and as you weave them a certain way under and over each other, building that potential energy, once it gets to the end, you create a trigger. We're going to release it, and it's going to create kinetic energy, and it's going to go boom, and it's going to blow all the way across the table. You ready? Let's start.
With red.
Red and orange. Three. This is about Bernoulli's principle. He was a guy from a long time ago who discovered stuff about air pressure. Okay, so we're balancing between low pressure and high pressure, okay? We're gonna take his hair dryer. Do you think we can make this float?
Yeah!
It's almost like magic.
Like magic?
But it's not. It's science. Ready. Set, are you ready? Go. Try this again. Only we're gonna up the airflow. Okay. Okay, so check this out. This is another example of Bernoulli's principle. What we're going to do is we're going to take this toilet paper and watch. Daddy blows across the top of it. I'm blowing air across the top, but it's actually causing the bottom of it to lift up. Yes. And that's what we're going to do. Are you ready for this?
Yes.
Okay, Gideon.
We're going to do the hose.
Yeah, we're ready.
What?
Let's have mommy come with us. Come on.
Okay, come over here.
Really fast.
So we got a bunch of string here. Daddy tied it around the doorknob, right? I took a piece of straw, cut the piece of straw, put it on the string, okay? We're going to try a big balloon first. This one gets really big. Really big. Stop it.
Come on.
Okay, now we're going to take tape. We're going to try this with a big round balloon first. Now what we've done is we filled this big balloon up with a bunch of pressure, okay? So air pressure is really high in there, and so there's particles that are just bouncing around like crazy, dying to escape. So what we're gonna do is we got a clothespin on the end, we're gonna let it out, pressure's gonna release, and it's gonna send the balloon flying that way.
There
it goes! All right, now we got a cylinder-shaped balloon. We're gonna test to see if this one goes faster. Are we ready?
Yeah.
Mommy, you ready?
Ready.
Yep. One, two, three. Whoa! You see how fast that was? Three, two, one, go! Whoa!
That is a
lovely
car. Thank you for watching Science.
We did force and motion experiments, which was really fun. We don't just do science videos, we do gaming videos. We do videos about toys, unboxing, and all kinds of stuff.
Oh, and the giveaway.
It's up there.
It's up there.
It's about our giveaway video. Yeah. We're doing a 100 subscriber giveaway video.
Yes.
So check that out. And enter the contest. Yes. You can win a $25 Amazon gift card.
And on Facebook.
Yeah, we're on Facebook. We always have a link to our Facebook page in the description. It's facebook.com/Gideon's World. It keeps up with all the cool stuff that we're doing. We also do behind the scenes pictures and stuff like that. So be sure to check us out, like us, and follow us there.
Click this button down and please subscribe.
Like this video, leave comments if you got them. Any suggestions for upcoming videos? We do new videos every week, don't we?
Yeah, and every single week.
And who knows what we're going to do next?
Thank you for watching Gideon's World of Science.
Yeah, we'll see you guys next time.
See you guys later. Bye, kids.
Today we're going to make a famous elephant toothpaste. We're not only going to make one, but we're going to make four. You're going to need hydrogen peroxide, dishwashing liquid, dry yeast, and food coloring. Let's be like real scientists, but we want to be safe, so let's put some safety goggles on. Hydrogen peroxide can irritate your skin and eyes, so let's keep our safety goggles on for the whole time. First thing we're going to do is pour half a cup of hydrogen peroxide in each bottle. Hydrogen peroxide in the bottle. Now we're going to pour 8 drops of food coloring in the bottles. We're going to pour 1 tablespoon of dishwashing liquid in each bottle using a funnel. Let's switch the bottle to mix it up. What we're going to do is put some dry yeast in each of these containers and water.